All right, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, let's start the evening. Welcome to the 9th Annual NEN Awards. My name is Daniel Holmesy. I'm the director of the Name Empowerment Network, and it's a real honor to be here tonight. This is a fantastic turnout. We had one of our largest responses ever to this evening's weekend, event, so thank you so much for coming. As for many of you may know, this is a ceremony we do every year to really honor the people that do the work in our neighborhoods. And I just want to acknowledge all the city agencies and department heads and elected officials that are here as a real example of how much we know you make a difference in making this city great. And so with that, I just want to thank you personally for the chance to work with you and help you achieve those goals. And I want to take a minute now and just bring you to speed a little bit about some of the stuff we've done together in just the last year. Over here, we had a fantastic year where we actually launched something called the NeighborFest program. In neighborhoods across the city, working with our partner at SF Safe, we actually brought a new strategy for block parties, where in addition to getting together and having fun, we actually now have a chance to help you write a disaster response plan for your block. And here you can see my son at Joxio, thanks to a very generous donation from Recology. In addition, you also get a bin of disaster supplies. And so this is a program we've been piloting with SF Safe, and we're hoping to roll it out next year. And I hope all of you to choose to participate in this program. It's a lot of fun. We also extended our strategy for neighborhood preparedness by advancing the Hub program in our city as well. And here you see four neighborhoods which participated: the Bayview, Mira Loma Park, OMI, and the Sunset, each of them launching what we call a hub in their neighborhood that will work together after disaster to help people successfully negotiate whatever stress comes their way. Lastly, we want to thank the leadership of many of our neighbors that came together to work with us on a concept that I've been trying to push across the finish line for many years, and that's the creation of a leadership academy here in San Francisco. How many people in this room feel they're a leader in their community? Come on, show me. I know a lot of leaders out in this room, please. But how many of you think we need more leaders in our communities? Amen. And so with that, I want to acknowledge the fact that we have a fantastic new partner with an organization called Coro here in San Francisco. And this year we hope to pull off creating the first leadership academy here in the city that helps people achieve the condition where they can actively contribute to the success of their neighborhood as residents and volunteers. Now, right now we have 8 neighborhoods participating in one variety or another in some of our programming. I want to take a moment though and thank our sponsors for tonight's evening. We wouldn't have been able to do it without our immense support that we get from our Community Challenge Grant Program, Lenita Enriquez and her work in the city. All of you know Lenita, how much she cares about the neighborhoods, and her support for this event is unmatched. We also want to thank our friends at Sterling Bank, Recology, and AT&T for their support for this evening as well. Also, of course, all of us love our dear and trusted friends at SAFE. They're an amazing organization, and I want to thank them for being our fiscal sponsor now for the 9th year in a row. And the many partners that we have. Yeah, a round of applause for SAFE, right? In addition, I want to thank our organizational partners, NERT, Public Works, I got that right, Rachel, SFDEM, the City and County of San Francisco, the City Administrator's Office, the Mayor's Office, our partners at ALERT, the Mayor's Office of Neighborhood Services, led by my good friend, Derek Brown, the Invest in Neighborhoods program at the Mayor's Office of Economic and Workforce Development, the Rec and Park Department, and of course, our friends at the Office of Economic Workforce Development. So with that, I want to begin our ceremony tonight with an award that we feel is one of the most important and prestigious, and that is the NEN Hall of Fame. And with that, I'd like to introduce the person I work for, City Administrator Naomi Kelly, her husband Harlan, and ask her to make some remarks and introduce the NEN Hall of Fame Award. Naomi?
Good evening, everyone. So I would be remiss to say that this is one of my if I don't mention it, this is one of my favorite events every year. I started my career, and I probably told you this every year, with the Mayor's Office of Neighborhood Services. And the neighborhood networks, the merchant associations are so important to the fabric of this city in that you are the backbone. If there's an emergency, you are the ones who all of us in our neighborhoods are gonna go to make sure that we are all taking care of each other. And I can't thank you enough for participating and doing all the great work you do. So can you all give yourselves a round of applause? I have the honor tonight to talk about introducing to the Hall of Fame Espinola Jackson. And when there was a survey that went out, she was the top vote getter amongst every category. And the reason I'm up here with my husband tonight, Harlan Kelly, he's not only just my husband, he's also the general manager of the San Francisco Public Utilities Commission. And he has, although I knew Espinola, and I think back regularly about Espinola because my office is over there on the Van Ness side of City Hall, and I would look out my window and watch her come and park in the parking space right in front of my office as she was coming into City Hall to tell us all what we needed to know about what was going on in the community. And we would sit there, if she showed up unannounced, we took that meeting with her because she would school us on what's going on. We'd also go out to her neighborhood and meet with her at her house, and she would drive us around the Bayview and give you a history lesson of what was landfill, where each church was, what is the environmental health issues that are happening because of the landfill that happened at this spot. And wouldn't say, these are the things you need to look at and you need to fix down there at City Hall. Trust me, baby, I know. And I looked forward to that, and I valued that time with her, and I actually missed that. And so with that, before I get into giving the award to Miss Gwen Jackson, her daughter, I think I'd be remiss because her fight and her partnership was with the SFPUC and the Southeast Community Facility and the Sewer System Project, and that's why I felt important that my husband come up and say a few words.
Thank you. So Espinola, actually, she's responsible for a lot of stuff in my career. She really supported me becoming the general manager because she knew my heart is with the community. She has really fought to make sure that our treatment plant that we put in the Southeast Community Facility was one that the community can be proud of, which at the time, it really didn't leave up, really met the expectation that the community had. And so as part of the mitigation, we did this community college where she fought to make sure that the PUC, or at that time, the Department of Public Works, put a community facility in there. And so I had the opportunity, right before her death, we actually sat down with her and I brought a vision. The vision was, we are going to do right by the community. We're going to spend $2 billion in upgrading this treatment plant so that it'll be a place of destination. On top of that, one of the mitigations, we had the community site or community facility where we had community college. What we're doing now, and I've been working closely with Gwen, is that we're going to move the community center not on Oakdale where it's at, we're going to move it 3rd and Evans, so it's right on the T line. But what we're going to do is we're going to work with community college and state to actually build an educational facility right there in a brand new community center for the community. And that's something that hopefully it will get done before I retire. And Gwen has been working with me, but it's really a vision of your mom. And so I just wanted to thank your mom and you for helping us really make that vision a reality. So thank you very much.
And with that, we would like to do the Espinola Jackson Hall of Fame. And Gwen, we have some flowers and awards for you. And do you have a few words to talk? Oh, yeah, let's see. How do we coordinate this?
Yeah, you can. Thank you, Naomi and Mr. Harlan Kelly. I was told to have, you know, some words regarding my mom. So I'm gonna do as fast as I can, but bear with me, I'm not a public speaker, not like my mom. I cannot wear her shoes. That's a big shoes to wear. Even though she was small in gender, she has some big shoes to wear, okay? So my mother was born in Charlotte, Texas on February 9, 1933. She moved to the Bayview Hunters Point in 1948. She moved and lived in public housing from 1954 to 1969 until the Lord blessed her to own her own home. She attended Girls House located in the Fillmore District. She also attended State College and she majored in communication and civil rights. She had a natural ability to recall the past. In my heart of hearts, my mother had a photographic memory. My mother was a proud mother of 6 children, 22 grandchildren, 45 great-grandchildren, and 3 great-great-grandchildren with 5 generations and was loved by all. She was a community activist for over four decades. She fought for the San Francisco residents to access a safe environment where everyone was to be treated equally. And she definitely spoke her mind for what was right. She was just a born leader. In the late 60s, I remember my mother carrying a gun in her purse when she went to the community meetings. And I asked her why. She stated, when people disrespect others and get rude, out of order, she had to bring them back to order and demand respect that when she put on her gun on the table, placed on the table, there was no sergeant at arms. And thank God, she didn't have to shoot anyone. In mid-1970, the Lord prepared my mother for a more excellent way. She put away her gun and she began to carry her Bible and he helped her with the scriptures. She was a praying woman, a woman of faith and a divine love for God, and she was chosen to lead. She set out to make changes for justice, quality and recognition for the city that needed her to make a difference, which otherwise probably would not have been happened. Just to say, she had a photographic memory when she attended meetings, and she presented the facts, not the alternative facts. Okay, thank you. She cared so much about her community. In 1973, she formed a group that consisted of through the mitigation for the sewers waste community where the Bayview Hunters Point had to endure that smell in her early 50s. The outcome was to compensate the community with an educational building, which is the Southeast Community Facility that was dedicated on November 18, 1986. She also organized 15 welfare rights public houses in San Francisco, and through the organization, she became the California state president of the welfare rights movement. She was so inspired to get involved with the Earth Day here in the Bayview, the solar, and she made sure that 30% of the jobs of the zip code areas for the residents be hired when the builders had come in. And she also worked with John Avalos to achieve the Loken hollering. Loken, thank you, Loken. And I can't permit time won't permit for me to say everything for all the things she did. But I wanna say, as Mel Ellie stated so well, her dedication to the community is unmatched. Okay, she made sure that the city government listened to her diverse communities and understood the impact to work with families. However, she never asked for favors for her own. Therefore, I must say she earned the right to be called the icon and the champion of the people, and she fought into her end. Amen.
Amen.
I got one more. And I like to say, since my mother's passing a year ago, she passed away January 24th of last year. And I like to acknowledge and express our family gratitude that we see awards from the, I didn't know he was gonna be here today. on the PC General Manager, Mr. Harlan Carey, for recognizing and honoring her with the most beautiful proclamation I ever seen, and allowed me to participate with the community meetings with the option to renovate or build new for the new Southeast Community Facility on 3rd and Abbott. Thank you. Amen. I'm thankful. I didn't know he was going to be here. And to the DPW staff for planting that Coast Lilac tree, dedicating her name on 3rd and Evans, adjacent to the main post office there. And then for everyone that shared in my mom's homegoing service, to everyone pray with us, send cars, flowers, food, and help with the expense. We appreciate you and thank you all. And last, I was told to say, if my mother was standing here, what would she say? Okay, this is what my mother would say. She would say, as she was standing here, the first thing she would say, all right now. She made it to the Hall of Fame. The gift bestowed on her dedication and impacting the lives of others is definitely has its rewards. Secondly, she would say, leave my building alone. And she wants people to educate ourselves, keep the fight, and work together and try to come to some kind of common ground and live a life that would impact others that we never be forgotten as it is today. God bless you all in Jesus' name. And today we acknowledge and appreciate the Neighborhood Empowerment Network for selecting our mom, Dr. Espinola Jackson, and to esteem her with that Hall of Fame award. We accept this award in my mama's name, and thank you for everything. And Daniel, thank you.
You did a wonderful job.
Check, check.
I just want to say that I'm glad that I met your mom when she was carrying the Bible and not the gun.
Awesome. Wonderful.
Bravo.
They told me to go this way and go to my side. Okay, thank you so much.
Wonderful. What a great way to start the evening. I don't think any of us can find a better role model than an Espinola Jackson. The first time I met Espinola, I was actually in my car on 3rd Street, and she was, I believe, running for office at that time. And she was in the street walking up to people in their car, and she walked up to my window and she said, you know, baby, you gotta vote for me. And I said, okay. And then she goes, who's that? I go, it's Gavin Newsom. She's like, oh, get out of the car, I'm talking to you. And we had to stop the car. And Gavin, of course, not his first and not his last opportunity to get it straight. So with that, we're going to move the program forward here. I want to invite my colleague to the stage right now, a gentleman who needs no introduction, but I'll do it anyhow. And that's a gentleman who's actually come to our city and made a huge contribution in his role in the Office of Economic Resource Development, and that is Joaquin Torres.
Thank you so much, everybody, for coming out tonight and supporting our neighborhoods and all of the extraordinary people here who put so much time and effort and love into their work to make our city a beautiful place for us to live and enjoy. My name is Joaquin Torres. I'm the Deputy Director of the Office of Economic and Workforce Development, and I lead Mayor Lee's Invest in Neighborhoods initiative. And I do just want to reinforce again that it's because of the leadership of those who we're honoring tonight that make our city so special. And I'm so, so pleased to be part of this as always. And I do again want to give a big shout out to Daniel Holmesy and his leadership in making sure the NEN Awards continue year after year after year. So I would like to invite up to the stage two of our next winners. And I've been told by Daniel to keep this very, very short. So I am going to be inviting up Anite Ekanem, who is a winner of the Exemplary NERT Leadership Award. And Ken Craig, who is a winner of the Exemplary ALERT Leadership Award. So congratulations, Anite, on your award. And if you could briefly tell us what NERT is and why are you involved?
So NERT is the Neighborhood Emergency Response Team. And I'm involved because it's a foundational organization. And what do I mean by that? I'm also on the board of SF Safe, so I love everyone here who's associated with that. We have a deep partnership with SF Safe. In addition, ALERT, many of the ALERT members, actually all the ALERT members come from NERT. Over the years, NERT's trained 25,000 people in how to actually really do what's necessary to help their neighbors and themselves in times of crisis and an emergency. Those things are just so important to me, and there are a couple other things that really sort of drive me. First is Lieutenant Erica Articeros. She's been the heart and soul of NERT for so many years. So many years. Without her, literally, I don't know how we would do what we do. And I also want to thank the folks who have come before me, Gary Pingaris, as well as Gene Kim. They're just two individuals over the last few years who've won this award, and they've done such an amazing job. And I have the opportunity to not only do this in my neighborhood, but also do it citywide. And in closing, what I have to say is this. For you and others in the city, KISS are volunteers. And what I mean by that is keep it simple. Make it easy for us to get involved. On the NERT side, if you go to sffdnert.org, you can actually sign up for classes and get training right here, right now. We also want you to be SF ready. And please, everyone, this time next year, if each one of you does not have a gallon of water per person and per dog in your household for not 3 but 5 days, we're gonna have an issue. Really, thank you so much. I really appreciate each and every one of you, and I'm actually in awe of being up here, not only with these folks, but really with all of you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Anite. And congratulations, Ken, on your award. You know, ALERT is a relatively new program. Can you tell us what its mission is and why you're involved?
Sure. The ALERT stands for Auxiliary Law Enforcement Response Team. The concept is to find and train volunteers that either live or work within San Francisco to respond for any city disaster to help the city recover, but also during non-disaster times to assist the police department or law enforcement in certain specified tasks where we would be useful to help them out.
Well, fantastic. And who did you bring with you today?
I have my husband, Paul, and also the program coordinator, Mark Hernandez, who does an amazing job at keeping all of this going. And could I mention? And if I could also mention, we have in the audience Captain David Lazar, and he is the person that actually made this all happen from an idea from Captain Steve Tashini. He came up with the original idea, but Captain Lazar definitely helped to kick it off, along with a development team, including Lieutenant Articeros.
Fantastic. Well, congratulations again to you, two award winners. Let's give them a big round of applause.
Nite, I've got 10 gallons of water per person per hour. Nah, we're a very thirsty bunch, us Mira Loba Parkians. With that, we'd like to bring on our next set of winners for the Most Empowering City Employee of the Year Award, Most Inspiring Public Works Volunteer, and Youth Neighborhood Leadership Award.
So if we can go ahead and welcome to this stage Victoria Weatherford, winner of the Most Empowering City Employee Award. Carla Jones, winner of the Most Inspiring Public Works Volunteer. And Eric Lopez, winner of the Neighborhood Youth Leadership Award. Well, congratulations, Victoria, on your award. Can you briefly tell us about your agency and how and what you do to help our neighborhoods?
Sure. So I'm with the city attorney's office. And what we do is I'm on a team of lawyers that does code enforcement. And we're called Neighborhood and Resident Safety. We bring lawsuits on behalf of the city to enforce our city codes, whether it's suing Academy of Art University for their decade of lawless development, shutting down legal gambling shacks on Mission Street, protecting tenants against unlawful harassment and evictions, and yeah, just did a 10-week trial. and you know, protecting, again, tenants against slumlord conditions and protecting the public against hazardous and dangerous safety conditions all over the city, cases big and small.
Well, thank you so much, Victoria, and congratulations. Congratulations, Carla, on your award. So you're a graffiti watch volunteer in the Middle Polk neighborhood. And how important is graffiti abatement for the beauty of our city?
I don't know about the rest of you, but I hate graffiti in my neighborhood. So I'm out there painting it. If you're coming to my neighborhood, don't have a paintbrush on, do any graffiti in my neighborhood. Be a graffiti watch volunteer in your neighborhood.
Thank you so much, Carla. Congratulations. And congratulations, Eric Lopez. Who do you have with you here tonight?
My mom.
And is she an inspiration for you?
Yes, she's helped me in a lot of ways.
So will you tell us how you're contributing to all the amazing work that you're doing in the Excelsior?
I am volunteering with multiple organizations around the Excelsior. Currently with the Excelsior Action Group, I try to help out with volunteer coordination, and I volunteer wherever I'm needed and whenever I can help.
And if you have one inspiring thing to say for the youth who are going to do the work after you, what would it be?
Just keep doing what they do and never give up on volunteering. It'll help you a lot in the future.
Well, fantastic. Congratulations, Eric. Congratulations to all of you, and thank you so much for coming out tonight. Mm-hmm.
Just amazing. You can't help but appreciate having Carla and Eric next to each other, right? Who's got more energy? It's a tie. It's fantastic. And also, I just want to acknowledge that, well, Eric's clearly a gentleman of modesty. The truth is, I think the people that nominate him were more excited and enthusiastic about it. Who here thinks that Eric deserved this award tonight here? Huh? How many people nominated him? It was crazy. I kind of felt bad. I didn't know who he was when I got all the nominations that came in the system. With that, though, let's return to our next set of awards. Joaquin, can you invite him up?
Yes, we have Newton Morse, the Newton Morse Curtis Watch Group for the Outstanding Neighborhood Watch Award. Please come on up. And the Friends of Franklin Square Park for Outstanding Park Volunteer Group. So Grace and the other members of Neighborhood Watch, congratulations on your award. Can you briefly tell us why you formed your Neighborhood Watch group, and has it helped improve safety in your community?
Yes, we formed our Neighborhood Watch group because my co-captain's house was broken into and I looked like one of the suspects. So we realized we didn't really know our neighbors. And what we were able to do when we formed and worked with SAFE was shut down a drug house and start work on beautification and give people a real ownership in the neighborhood.
Well, fantastic. Do you have anything else? All right, well, congratulations. Let's have a round of applause. Let me sneak right behind you. So I'm joined here by Jolene Yee and Jesse Stewart. Congratulations on your award. Who wants to tell me why you formed the Friends of Franklin Square Park, and what is your proudest accomplishment to date?
Well, I formed Franklin Square Park because of the fact that as a mom of two young children, I read them a lot of stories, and one of their favorite ones is The Lorax by Dr. Seuss. And there's a famous line in there where it says, unless someone like you cares a whole awful lot, nothing's going to change for the better, nothing. And that's really why this activism of our neighborhood is so important. I want to thank you, all of Trumark Urban's efforts in improving our park. We're so proud of the fact that together we've invested over 4,000 hours of public service to clean our park and to build rainforests, as well as to work on our grants. So we're very, very proud and excited. I want to thank our supervisor, Supervisor Cohen, as well as our fiscal sponsor, San Francisco Parks Alliance. Thank you so much, and I'm so honored to accept this on behalf of our neighbors.
Well, congratulations to both of you. Let's have a great round of applause. Okay. Thank you. Congratulations.
Wonderful. What an amazing group of people. Why don't we just also take a second? I believe we have three captains joining us tonight. Captain Lazar, Flaherty, and our good friends, Mr. McFadden. Captain McFadden, are you here? Can you please stand, please, captains? There's David right there. Where's McFadden? There, and Flaherty as well. Those may recall last year was the McFadden show. Captain did a fantastic job. But we all know that having community policing-centric captains makes a huge difference in our efforts to make our neighborhoods safer. So we want to thank them for their service here. I also want to take a minute and acknowledge that one of our members from the school board, from the community college committee, Raphael Mendelman, is here, I believe. Raphael, back there. There he is. Also fellow alumni from Lick Wilmerding High School. And I also want to acknowledge that we are honored to receive certificates tonight for our winners from David Chu, our assembly person, as well as Supervisor Malia Cohen. And with that, I'll kick it back to Joaquin for our next winners.
Certainly, and I also want to recognize our newly elected state senator, Scott Weider, who's in the House tonight. Thank you for joining us tonight. We've got a great group of winners that are going to join us now. The Cassava Neighbor Fest for the Extraordinary Neighborhood Block Party. The Castro Upper Market Community Benefit District for Best Merchant Association and Community Benefit District. And the Friends of Kenny Alley for Best Community Challenge Grant Project. So I have with me here Maxine Kramer and a few of her neighbors on Cassava. Congratulations, Maxine, on your award and to all of you. Can you briefly tell us why your community decided to participate in the NENS NeighborFest program, and what was your favorite part of the event?
Well, we decided to participate because we were a newly formed neighborhood watch, and we got the notice from NEN, from Daniel Holmesy, inviting us to participate, and we thought, okay, let's go ahead and do it.
Well, that's fantastic. Congratulations on your award tonight. And I would like to invite up State Senator Weiner, who I know wanted to present to his Castro group.
Great. Good evening, everyone. First of all, I wanted to say thank you to everyone who works in their neighborhood to make your neighborhood a better place. It really is some of the most underappreciated work, where people, for no pay, for just the love of it, are working day in and day out to improve their neighborhood. So let's hear it for everyone who works so hard every day. And so, even though they sent me up to Sacramento, this is home, and so I'm back. And I want to, I'm just so thrilled that the Castro Upper Market Community Benefit District is being recognized tonight. For the 6 years that I had the honor of representing District 8 on the Board of Supervisors, the Castro CBD was a key partner to my office in making sure that my neighborhood, where I live, was really moving forward. And Andrea Aiello and her board and her whole team, I cannot overstate the work that they do to keep a very challenging neighborhood in terms of the amount of pedestrian traffic, the usage, some of the conflicts in the neighborhood, and they've just done masterful work. We did a huge project on Castro Street where we almost doubled the width of the sidewalks and just revolutionized the Castro Street commercial corridor. And Andrea and the CBD, it couldn't have happened without your support and being on the ground every day. So thank you so much for everything that you guys do. And I have a certificate of honor for you.
Thank you so much, Senator. So I'm now joined by Andrea Aiello, Executive Director of the Castro Upper Market Community Benefit District. Congratulations again on your award. Your organization has done a wide variety of innovative and progressive initiatives, tackling some of our most difficult problems in our public spaces. Which are you most proud of?
Well, we keep the district really clean and graffiti free. But we've done some really, really creative things. We, with State Senator Scott Wiener with the sidewalk widening project. We have these beautiful rainbow crosswalks at 18th and Castro that the Community Benefit District paid for. And in May, we're going to be installing a really creative, unique LED light installation, a public art project in the Castro called The Seed. And it's going to be at the Jane Warner Plaza. We're really excited. It's going to be installed May 21st, so come on out. And the other thing that we're really, really proud of is all the small businesses and restaurants that are in the Castro. It's really a fun place. It's safe. And please come out and enjoy the Castro.
Congratulations, Andrea, and to the entire Castro Upper Market Community Benefit District. I'm also joined by Mel Flores from representing the Friends of Kenny Alley on behalf of the group. Congratulations on your award. Can you tell us some more about the project and how it has helped the community?
Sure, I'm really honored to be here representing a multitude of neighbors, volunteers, community members, donors. I'm here with some of the original Friends of Kenny Alley, Summer Coity, Stephanie Kahina, there's Roseanne Harris, Grace Dianca, our lead artist, Kim Jensen. And I think the most significant thing is that we took essentially a neglected public space, just a kind of a grungy alley, and essentially have created a work of art within the neighborhood. And we've done that with, of course, the support of the Community Challenge Grant Program and Lenita Enriquez and SF Public Works, SF Parks Alliance, City Arts and Technology High School, and a lot of the volunteers came from there, and many others that we're really grateful for their support. We're not finished yet. We have more plans, and we invite everyone to join us to be our friends and help us there and evolve and beautify our wonderful world in the Excelsior. So thank you.
Thank you so much, Mo. We have a round of applause for this great, great group of award winners. Thank you so much.
Wonderful. I'm glad whoever designed this building made the steps that wide up there. What a great turnout. I'll take a minute and thank Assessor Carmen Chu for providing certificates for tonight's winners. And also Captain Lum has joined us as well. Captain Lum has joined us here this evening as well. So I have to say the next award is one of my favorites. It really honors, the overarching mission of this organization. But in addition to this award, I have to acknowledge that also issuing the award this year is also one of my favorites. Derek Brown with the Mayor's Office of Neighborhood Services. Derek, take it away.
Thanks, buddy. Thank you. You know what?
Hey, Chuck.
Let's give all the awardees another hand so far. Excellent. Incredible. Also, I feel like I'm at the Academy Awards. Joaquin, Daniel, you guys are crushing it. Great job. Let's give them a hand as well.
Excellent.
As Daniel mentioned, my name is Derek Brown, Director of the Mayor's Office of Neighborhood Services, and it is truly an honor to be here. And I reached out to Daniel, and I said, you know what? Let me give Joaquin a break, and let me introduce one of my favorite awards, and that's the Comeback Neighborhood of the Year. And today, I'm here to announce Outer Sunset Community. Let's come out. Comeback Neighborhood of the Year. Come on. Thank you. I'm gonna wait for them to get up. I have a few questions for them, but you guys come up, take your time. You guys look amazing, still coming? Okay, excellent, let's do it. Okay, let me scoot back a little bit. You guys, come on up. Is that everybody? Okay. Yes. So, Krista, question for you.
Great.
How does this feel?
Hi, this feels amazing. Thank you so much for being here. It's really, truly an honor to be here.
Thank you. And we also have Supervisor Tang. Would you like to say some words? How do you feel about this? I know you feel excited.
I don't think we had a comeback. We were always a hip neighborhood. Look at all these people up here. So
there are so many people here who make the sunset amazing. I'm going to miss a few people because there's so many here, but we've got Bill from our Outer Sunset Merchant Association. We've got Benny, we've got Sam, we've got Dar, so many other merchants here on Irving Street. We have our captain, Denise Flaherty, Laura and Angie, who started a new Sunset Mercantile, Margaret, who helped out with emergency preparedness, John and Krista here, who've done so much around Neighborhood Watch and helped us transform an empty school facility into a playland at 43rd Avenue. There's so many more, Dave and Les back there, guys from the Riptide, who helped transform Lower Terravel Street. Susan and Chris, who also helped out with Playland. Don, I'm sorry, from Irving Street. So just so many people to thank. And I'm going to turn over to Bill really quick.
I understand I have 1 minute, so it's like winning the Academy Award. So if I go over my minute, the music comes on. My name is Bill Barnacle. I'm president of the Outer Sunset Merchant Association. And also, I am a commissioner for Veterans Affairs for City County of San Francisco. So shout out to my vets and retired. Thank you. So I want to thank you for me for accepting this award for the community. It's not about us, it's about the community. And we have quite a few merchants here from the Outer Sunset as well as the community. The first one I want to introduce to is World Team USA, my instructor at the young age of 65 years old. I'm taking kickboxing. And because of him, I'd probably be a lot heavier, but now I lost 15 pounds. So Cruz Sam and his wife, World Team USA. And then they're giving discounts. We have a couple of banks. The banks aren't here. We have the SFPD, Denise Flattery, Captain. I want to thank you for all the efforts you've done for the Sunset District and the beat officers, because without you, now we have a safer neighborhood, and I really appreciate it. Thank you. I'm back. What happened?
I'll finish when you're
finished?
Done. I'll take it.
I finished? Well, I'm finished. Sorry.
Hi. So, again, I just want to thank you all for being here. The Outer Sunset and the Sunset is not necessarily where people think of going and spending a lot of their time, except I encourage you all to come. There's something about the air and the light, the fact that it's at the very end of the world, that when you stand on the great highway, you're looking out into the horizon. And what the Outer Sunset and the Sunset has is this sense of space, and in that space is where people put their hopes and they see possibility. So the question to me was, what is it about your neighborhood that deserves this comeback award? And I really want to say it's the people that are there that bring their passion. And there's something about the air and the space of the sunset that encourages people's passion. And the last thing to say is, what's so exciting about a neighborhood award is that it gives us a chance to speak about being a neighborhood. And in the days ahead, I think the things that will mean the most are the kindnesses that we give to each other. Nowhere is that easier to find and to grow and to nurture than in a neighborhood. The way that we look out for each other, that we care for each other, that work we do in a neighborhood is probably the most important work we can do, because it grows out from there. So I know I can speak for everyone up here. We have an amazing neighborhood. We really have a great affection for each other and a respect for each other's passions. So thank you so much for giving us a chance to speak to that.
Let's give Outer Sunset another hand. Thank you.
Thank you.
A big round of exit applause for these winners. Congratulations to all of you again. And I understand that I'm bringing up a representative from Supervisor Safai's office to make a few remarks.
In one moment, that's a great idea. I'll be right there. You kidder, always trying to mix it up. Before we move further in the program, I want to just take a second and thank a few folks and organizations that really make this event happen. First of all, I want to thank the building management team here. This is an amazing building. Putting things like this together doesn't happen overnight. Look at my cool ramp I got this year. So just want to thank them for the hard work they do. I also want to thank our friends in the events department and the folks in our sound and audio department here at City Hall as well. They do a lot of work to make this a success. And also our friends at SFGovTV, who always seem to make sure that we end up looking good on film. And I look a little taller every year. That's why I put Joaquin over there, so I look taller. So with that, I do want to announce and introduce our final and last award, and that is, of course, the NEN Lifetime Hall of Fame, Lifetime Achievement Award. Joaquin?
Yes, but first, I want to introduce Kathy Meyer from Supervisor Safai's office, who wants to make a few remarks.
Hello, everyone. On behalf of Supervisor Safai's office, I'm very honored to present this award to Mary Harris. Mary Harris is a person that proves that one person can make a difference. From her volunteer work as a PTA president, to her work with Coleman Advocates, and the work that she has done throughout the entirety of District 11. She is the president of the OMI Neighbors in Action Group. She works with the Excelsior Action Group as a board member. And for years, she has been unifying the east side and west side of 280 in District 11. So it's my extreme pleasure to introduce Mary Harris.
Thank you so much. I'd like to first introduce my family, my husband, Al Harris. This side. I don't know. Okay, this one. Okay, our oldest daughter is in Texas, Gina, so she can't be here tonight. Next, we have Becky, our middle child, and then her daughter, Skye, my granddaughter, Anthony, our son, Michael, Micaela, and the baby, Julie. In the audience is my favorite sister, Connie, and her husband, Ed, my niece, Susie, my nephew, Scott, and my boss for 40 years, Douglas Grigg. They are my second family. Douglas and Katri are my second family, and I couldn't work for a better family. So I'd like to thank all my family and my friends and everyone that's come out to celebrate with me tonight, and everyone who sent an email and a phone call and a note. It's really touched my heart. Thank you so much. I'd like to say how proud I am to be in the Lifer Club. That's what we call it, the Lifer Club, with the previous winners, and especially with Marlene, Mark, Roseanne, and Joelle, who are my friends, and I admire and respect the work that they have done. Over the last 25 years, I've had a lot of asks in the OMI neighborhood and District 11, and I would like to thank the mayors, the supervisors, the city departments, and the city workers who have responded to all these requests. Mayor Brown answered yes right away when we went to him and asked him for the first library to be built in 50 years. I'll never forget that day. Then there was the Board of Education when we went to ask for Sheridan School. That took 3 school bonds. That was hard work. And then there was the department head who absolutely said no way. No way, it's not happening. And I went stealth. I joined with another neighborhood group. He thought he was meeting with 25 people. The room was standing room only. We had signs. We had chants. He asked Al at the door if he was getting out alive. And Al said, only if you give her what she wants. He came in saying no. He signed the pledge. And we got what we needed for the youth in the OMI. I would also like to thank Ingleside and Terravel police stations. We've had the best captains from past to present. Tonight, Joe McFadden is here, and Captain Denise Flaherty, but we also have Captain Lazar, who was fabulous, and Captain Lum. Thank you for being here tonight. You are, You and your officers are true community partners, and we could not work on our public safety issues or any of our events without that partnership. I mean, they bring turkeys. When I said chickens weren't good enough on Thanksgiving for our low-income families, they came bringing turkeys. And when I say we don't have toys for the kids, they come bringing toys. They are true partners in every sense of the word, and I thank you so much. In 1999, we formed the District 11 Council. At any given time, it's composed of 12 to 14 groups, and each one of those individuals devotes hundreds of hours every year to their community. Many have received NEN awards and are here tonight. I would like to thank them for their support and their friendship. San Francisco is a better city because of you, and most of you are our closest and dearest friends. Thank you. I know that that giving up that much personal time and commitment is impossible for everyone, but I would like to ask that we all do what we can. First, by being prepared for any event of an emergency with a to-go kit and emergency supplies by going to sf72.org. Having a family meetup plan and a out-of-state contact. Next, Neighbors in Action has a tagline that I put on every letter that I write, and it says, a community of neighbors helping neighbors. I would like that to be a San Francisco value. A San Francisco value of neighbors helping neighbors. If you see something, say something. If you see something that doesn't look right, if people are going through looking in car windows, trying the knobs, taking packages off the door, those aren't your neighbors, please call the police. If you see litter, please pick it up. If you can't, please call 311. Get to know your neighbors, get to know each other, especially seniors and disabled. If there's a power outage, a heat wave, a fire, or earthquake, please check on your neighbors, especially your seniors. Make sure they aren't burning candles, they aren't dehydrated, or they haven't fallen. This is something we can all do in all of our neighborhoods. So let's make that neighbors helping neighbors a San Francisco value, please. Thank you. So now I'm getting ready to wind up here. You guys are hungry, but I saved the best for last. I'd like to thank my husband, Al Harris. We've been together 40 years, 36 on Valentine's Day. He is my partner in crime and my true best pal. We call each other pal all the time instead of our names, unless we're mad at each other and I can't tell you those other names. He supports me in everything I do. He has never said no to any of my dreams or plans. He has never complained on how late I've come home. And I'll remember that meeting with Gavin Newsom that lasted till 5 in the morning. Or the dinner that didn't get made when we've had grilled cheese, a can of soup, or a salad. Never once has he complained. He took care of our daughter when I joined Coleman Advocates to learn public speaking and how to navigate City Hall. After she graduated high school, he joined me in all the boards and committees I was on, and even did some other things like the Friends of the Geneva Office Building, the African American Chiefs Forum, and he became a library commissioner. All this is to say that Al deserves this award as much as I do, and thanks to Daniel Holmesley and his infinite wisdom, he has made this happen. Please join me in congratulating Al Harris on the Lifetime Achievement Award.
I wasn't expecting that. A lot of the things she says is true. But what are you going to do as your wife if you say if you say no, it doesn't go very well. So thank you, everyone. I really appreciate it.
Awesome. That was just worth it just to see Al without a baseball hat on. That was fantastic. Well, I want to just join the winners up here on stage here as we wrap this thing up, just because I think Mary and Al embody the spirit of what these awards are all about, and it really is true. I see them in neighborhood meetings in neighborhoods they don't even live in, right, all the time, and I just think that that's the spirit here in San Francisco. And I would just close on this, you know, and I think Joaquin joins me in this sentiment, is that how many people do you know that tell you they don't have time to get involved in their neighborhood, right? And like, oh, I so admire what you do, I just don't have the time to do it. And yet the people you see spending the time, you don't know where they get the time. And so I just want to put out there that these two are kind of the inspiration for my generation, if you will, even though Al and I did go to college together. And I just want to put out here that, you know, this is the reason why we're here tonight. So again, a round of applause for Mary and Al Harris, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, and so we'll invite them off the stage to take a last photo, but we'll just close on this. Without further ado, the reception is open. Taste Catering has put together an amazing event to us tonight. Thank you all for coming to 9th Annual Net Awards, and guess what? Next year is the 10th and most amazing Net Awards ever, so we'll see you next year. Thank you, Joaquin and Derek and all the volunteers.